all going to be silent anyway. Okay. She's her earphones in. She can't hear you.
Oh, I just didn't want to interrupt her. The kids want me to take them to the mall.
Yikes.
Is there a mall?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I need coffee.
For sure.
I brought some water. What makes you get started? What's your starting point in your mind?
Pretty much nothing. Yeah. My starting point is with a routine. So just putting on, for new point painting, putting on my canvas. And then my routine, if I want to call it, to lead me into a painting, for me to get, I don't want to say inspired, to get me going, mm-hmm. is using like the three colors, the unbleached titanium, the burnt sienna, and then the yellow ochre. And that gives me a starting point, and I need that. And I think everybody, it doesn't matter if you are an artist or if you have a different kind of job, you have to have a routine. And I think even as an artist, you have to have a routine.
Yeah.
To really leave your life behind, your regular life, mm-hmm. to jump into something different. So, and then of course my music. But I'm getting right now all kinds of artists. It also depends on the day. Sometimes I need my Simply Red fix.
Yeah. If you do something like with the charcoal or something, and then you decide you don't like it, how do you incorporate it into your painting? If there's some, you know, some line that you did that you maybe...
Well, that's good. You know, I work with the charcoal that I can just manipulate on the canvas very easily. And I like the spontaneous process in the beginning with acrylics because they dry fast and I can act really fast. So the beginning of my painting is really fast. So if I don't like a line or... something, I just wipe it off, I can use water, but it's so rough in the beginning. I try to not go into detail so that every line adds actually to the painting. like, I don't know if I'm gonna bind or that line later. It doesn't bother me so much. If it's too strong, I just wipe it off, or I could use some water. But it's very rough in the beginning.
Very rough.
So yeah. Yeah, even though I continue with oil at one point, I like to start with the acrylics.
Yeah.
They give me, I take advantage of both mediums, what they give me. And, yep.
Okay. Let's see.
I'm going to measure, I'm going to stretch it, because at this point I know where I want to have the painting. And then I'm going to start with the oils. So the colors, they're not so much of a problem. It's more the composition and that I get the hands right. It's very important to me because I think they are so crucial in a painting and the body language itself. So I want to get that right. There cannot be a question what this woman wants and is doing, at least for me. Everybody who looks at the painting, I mean, it's universal. Everybody has their own thoughts, but I want to get my thoughts in. And so for me, it has to be right. And there is, if I get too predictable in a painting, I just do something to kind of destroy it, so that I get, so I don't like a too predictable painting. It is, for me, it's boring. I need some excitement and something in it that is fresh. Yeah, maybe fresh isn't the right word. Something that leaves a question open.
Question for you, or an obvious question to whomever is viewing it?
Wow.
Is that intentional?
That's a good question. I don't know. So, I want the viewer, I want something mysterious, something they have to think about. And maybe something you see days later when you have a painting in your house, and days later you think like, what is that? And then you wonder about it. So if it's too predictable, too easy cut, it's not exciting for me. So I want a little more. I want mysterious. I want a face that you don't see. And sometimes I cover up faces, but I know they are there. So for me, it still exists. You know, it's like in life. There are people coming into your life and then they leave again, but you still remember them. So it's like in my painting, I remember the different steps.
What would you say the emotions are that are more prevalent in your paintings?
Being a woman, being vulnerable, but being strong at the same time. My picture of women is, I'm proud to be a woman, and it comes with certain
what is that?
What is it in German?
Things. So I love to cook. I love to do things that women like because I'm a woman. but I want to be taken seriously about it. You can have all those vulnerable feelings, but I think in my paintings you see a certain strength in the faces or in the even in the body language. It can be humbled but strong. I'm proud to be humbled. I'm proud to be in certain aspects vulnerable, because I think that's what makes a person human, is just saying how you feel without being judged and someone taken advantage of.
You mentioned hands. It seems to be an important thing to you.
Yeah. Hands are, you can describe a person by gesture with the hand. You know, you can have like, thinking. And you can have like, I'm against something maybe, or I'm strong. And so hands say a lot, because there are no words in a painting. So you have to show with body language and with gesture and with their faces what you want to say. It's my voice is their faces and their hands and their feet. Yeah, their body.
How many paintings do you think you've done?
Oh my gosh, I wish I knew. I'm not counting. I mean, I started very early. My father, even though he studied law, but he was a painter in his heart, so he got me started very early, like 5 or 6. I know every child paints and draws when they are young, but once he noticed that I have an interest in it, he never pushed me before, but once he noticed that, he would have me carry a sketchbook when we went places on vacation or such, and he would give me those postcards from famous artists, and I would copy them, and he wouldn't even help me much. So all those, I have lots of piles of drawings from long time ago, and then in school I'm not counting those. My serious paintings, once I started in, you know, galleries, serious galleries, not just shows, I would say 150 that have been or are in galleries and that I have done. But that's just a number. I don't know. It's when a painting is done, it's not the most important for me that it's done, but the making the painting, I'm alive, like it's no other feeling. I'm there in the present, even though I dive into a different world. But it's very real for me. So when a painting is done, I can also turn it around, pile it up. I don't have to look at the painting when it's done the whole time, because I did it. I did my part of creating it. And so the most satisfying part is actually painting it. And it's very nice seeing it on gallery walls, of course. And other people saying something about it. You need that. I mean, you cannot just paint in a bubble. But I'm most vulnerable to critique while I'm painting it, because I don't want people to influence me, because I want to say what I want to say, and afterwards it doesn't hurt me or it doesn't affect me anymore, because I made my decisions on my own. And yeah, just myself in there, so nobody else.
How do you know when you're finished?
Picasso had a saying, when there's nothing else to say. And it's how I feel when I get that feeling across, or that emotion, then I'm good. Of course, the hands or the problem solving is the last thing. And if that works, then it's good.
I'm going to, yeah, so that dry in here. I have to tweak something on this one. You didn't get dirty in my studio. You're not dirty.
Stay wet for quite a while, like 2 weeks or something, but these I'm concerned about.